Country, keeping the neighborhoods and communities that they serve safer.
Sheriff Stanek, what about those issues when it comes to assault weapons and high-capacity magazines? You heard Chief Major here talk about these kind of issues. Where do you and your organization stand on these kind of things?
Yeah, the Chief and I have had a chance to work on a number of these issues over the past year. The Major County Sheriff's Association, just the opposite in some terms, others, we come to agreement. The Major County Sheriff's Association did not support an assault weapons ban. We did not support bans on high-capacity magazines. We did agree on mental health. We agreed on a number of other issues moving forward. You know, the bottom line is that Major County Sheriff's Association felt that gun control in and of itself will not solve the complex problems of extreme gun violence across this country that's happening each and every day. And we shouldn't impose on the law-abiding rights, the Second Amendment rights of law-abiding citizens in order to solve that problem. Now, having said that, that's where Congress and that's where the legislators across this country have to figure out where they can come together and do something to reduce extreme gun violence in our community.
Again, our two gentlemen joining us for about an hour to talk about these issues, and you can ask them questions as well. Here's how you can do so.
These events and their causes to prevent future tragedies. Since 2007, according to the FBI, there have been 146 reported mass shootings. Far too often, a large contributing factor to this recent surge in violence is untreated mental illness. And far too many instances, the perpetrators are former members of our military. Our nation must bridge the gaps in our current mental health system to avoid more tragedies. The president recently unveiled his Brain Initiative. It calls for $100 million in funding to advance our understanding of the human mind. Supporting this proposal will go a long way to furthering our understanding of the causes and conditions that afflict those who wish to harm others and themselves. Further, Congressman McKinley of West Virginia and I have introduced H.R. 1615, the Examining America's Mental Health Services Act of 2013. The bill requires the Secretary of Health and Human Services and the National Academies Institute of Medicine to conduct a comprehensive study on the gaps in our nation's mental health services and explore how these gaps increase the risk of violent acts. Experts such as former Army Vice Chief of Staff Dr. Peter Chiarelli, Dr. Joseph Calabrese of Case Western Reserve University, U.S. Army Colonel Carl Castro, and Dr. E. Fuller Torrey, head of the Stanley Foundation, would be prime candidates to lead breakthrough national initiatives on mental health. Part of our comprehensive effort should focus on accelerating funding for brain research and neuropsychiatric treatment. Second, reforming military enlistment, discharge procedures, and integrating the Department of Defense and Department of Veterans Affairs medical record system. Third, instituting early childhood behavioral screening in schools. And fourthly, restricting gun and ammunition access to those who have serious behavioral disorders. Additional focus on mental illness and gun access is imperative. The Navy Yard tragedy.
Gun control is a very important issue, and it's a very challenging issue for society. On one hand, you have the rights of citizens to carry weapons and to have weapons in their house, and if they have weapons in their house, as long as they're properly storing them and properly training how to use them, I don't have a problem with them having the weapons. But what happens is a lot of times they're not stored properly, and either children get their hands on weapons, or else there's a break into a house where someone might steal a weapon. And if the guns get into the hands of the wrong person, bad things can happen. So it's kind of a two-way street, trying to balance the issue between gun control and the rights of citizens to carry. So
what are your thoughts on gun control?
Well, I'm in favor of gun control. I think that it is a great way to reduce crime in our communities. I think gun control will lessen the violence that currently exists. So I think if the tool is used correctly, that is, it will be great for our community.
Do you think gun control is used too much in today's society? And if you say yes, can you explain why?
Actually, I don't think it's used too much in today's society. I think that there should be stricter rules on gun control. I think that currently it is too easy for people to get guns. I think that there should be more scrutiny in terms of who is allowed to carry a weapon in this country. So I don't think it's used too much.
Guns affected your regular and work life?
Well, I have worked for a police department for 35 years, and I have seen the effects of guns. Both having to counsel victims and also being involved in the process of seeing people who are arrested for having guns. On a personal level, my brother was shot many years ago in New York City, and personally it was very devastating, not only to me but to my family. Saw what it did to him physically and emotionally. It's not something I would wish on anybody.
Look up in the sky, bet you recognize a boss. Look into my eyes as I fantasize for us. Still acting shy like this is a summer class crush. Money coming fast. I'm